kinds of exciting action, but right now, I believe we have with, yes, Jesse the Body Ventura, had the pleasure of interviewing the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions earlier on, and they have, I believe, a new mascot. Let's take you to the British Bulldogs.
This is Jesse the Body Ventura, and everybody knows I travel worldwide, and I always heard that English women had beautiful bodies, but not so beautiful faces. Well, I guess everybody was right. Davy Boy Smith, what is this?
Jesse, this is Matilda. A lot of people and a lot of wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation have managers, but we've got a new mascot called Matilda, and this dog is trained to attack.
That's right. Jesse, she is a full-blooded, purebred bulldog.
Purebred bulldog. Female. Girlfriend, maybe?
No, mascot.
Matilda, what do you got to say? Talks with about as much intelligence as an Englishman. What can I say? Jesse the Body Ventura, he sees it all right here in the World Wrestling Federation. New manager?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a non-title tag team matchup. It is scheduled for one fall.
You didn't mean what you said, Jesse, about
I'm about to
enter, women.
Introduce to you,
of course I did.
Coming down the aisle momentarily, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions from England at a total combined weight of 470 pounds, Davy Boy Smith, the Dynamite Kid, the British Bulldogs.
You know what I like, McMahon?
What's that?
Macho Man Savage has Elizabeth. Look what the British Bulldogs have.
Well, they got some cute little dog. By the way, as you heard from, I believe, Davy Boy, that bulldog is trained to go after people. What if he sicked him on you?
Well, there's one of the pretty federettes on hand. Holding, oh, look out! Here we go! What?
Valentine Beefcake wasting no time at all going to work on the British Bulldogs. Come on, ref, get control of this thing. Oh, come on.
Well, I'll tell you what, Beefcake and Valentine are wasting no time. Johnny V's got him going, but the Bulldogs, I'll tell you, the resilience of the Bulldogs is unbelievable. I will give him that credit, McMahon. They're tough guys.
Off the rope now. Back body drop. Nicely done by the Dynamite Kid. Drives the knee to the chest. No, the head of Greg the Hammer Valentine. Valentine just about as tough as they could get. Watch the suplex coming. Snap suplex down to the canvas. Bruno, have you ever seen anyone in pro wrestling ever execute the snap suplex like that?
Absolutely not. Never in history of wrestling. I've never heard of anybody who could come anywhere near doing a suplex with the speed and the dynamics of Dynamite Kid.
Davy Boy back in there now, winding up Greg the Hammer. You would think the Hammer is seeing a few cobwebs, maybe, and some stars to go along with it.
Well, I'm sure he is at this point, but I'll tell you, Greg the Hammer, Valentine's no newcomer to pain. He's a tough, tough guy. Come on. Look at the handful of hair. Now look at that. A flagrant hair pulling.
Yes, and the referee warned him, and you saw Davy Boy releasing the boom. My elbow is now Valentine, I believe. Yes, tagged Brutus Beefcake off the rope. Kick right into the chest area. A cover by Beefer. Two, and that's all he can get. Brutus Beefcake. Front face lock now on Davy Boy Smith, trying to set him up for the, yes, trying to get him up. Suplex down to the canvas.
That, I might add, wasn't a bad suplex either, McMahon.
No, it was not a bad one at all, but look who's recovering first.
Lowell, Massachusetts, a great city for the World Wrestling Federation this coming Tuesday night. The World Wrestling Federation indeed back in Lowell at the Lowell Memorial Auditorium with such stars as the Birdman, Coco Beware, Corporal Kirshner, Billy Jack Haynes, the sensational Honky Tonk Man, and the Junkyard Dog, all headed to the Lowell Auditorium, Lowell, Massachusetts, this Tuesday night.
Oh, my. Come on. Valentine Beefcake non-title matchup. This matchup means a great deal to them.
Valentine's cheating again.
No, he did not. That was a legal maneuver. Nicely done, I might add. Valentine going up to the top rope, and Dynamite beats him up. Valentine
grounds and a careless cover. That man, he can't. Too much second out of Dynamite. Now covering Valentine. Two. No, not enough there. Look of concern on the face a moment ago of Johnny V. This capacity crowd really enjoying the tag team matchups. Valentine continuing to hammer away, even though the tag is made to Brutus Beefcake. Now Valentine to the outside. Dynamite bearing the brunt thus far of the assault of Beefcake and Valentine. Look at that maneuver.
Ooh, whoa.
That could do it. We have a count of two.
That was actually a version of the Nikolai Volkoff backbreaker right there.
Somewhat. Remember, if Valentine, Beefcake are victorious, they will not win the titles, Jess.
Well, you know, I could believe that because I'm sure the Bulldogs are ducking every chance they can of putting the titles on the line. You know, a lot of champions are that way.
I don't think that's the case.
A lot of champions only defend that title when they're required to or be sued.
Tag is made now. Davey Boy in. He's been outside, and look at this. Pound for pound, one of the strongest athletes in the world today. Beef takes the ride. Drop kick. Davey Boy in control with Brutus Beefcake at the moment. And trying to set him up for another suplex. Yes. Beefcake down to the canvas. A cover. It's all over. We have two. And Mick.
No. Oh, he kicked out with authority right on top of Dave Hebner, the referee.
Look, Valentine. Did you see what he did?
That's right. Valentine saw his moment and got it in.
Referee Dave Hebner trying to clear up. Oh, come on, man.
What's one.
No, don't do that.
Two. Three. Wait, hey, how come he's not counting three?
Valentine's not the legal man in, that's why. It's supposed to be Beefcake in there. That's not Valentine. Thank goodness the referee came to his senses here. Johnny V on the outside. Come on, turn around, ref.
Ooh. Now they'll get the right man in there.
No, sorry. Take a hike. Mr. Val. Did he win it? Valentine and Beefcake think that they have won this matchup. I'm a little confused myself. They could very well have, although that did not exactly look like a pin to me.
The winners of this bout, as a result of a disqualification, the British Bulldogs!
All right! Calling it as it should be. That's not Danny Davis in there as the referee, I can tell you that.
Well, definitely not Danny Davis. This referee was a lot less competent than Danny Davis.
No, he called it like he saw it, and thank goodness he saw everything. The British Bulldogs, Dynamite Kid, Davey Boy Smith, victorious. And let's go back now to the replay, Bruno.
The disqualification took place simply because Beefcake, well, look at this. First of all, look at this power. Billy Boy Smith, Beefcake, pressed him overhead, gives him a tremendous body slam. But get back to the finale here. It was a disqualification. Look at this beautiful drop kick. Billy Boy Smith and Greg Valentine. But anyway, here's the wrong man's in the ring, and they both of them, Beefcake and Valentine, were there both together when they shouldn't have been in that cause of disqualification.
Is that any reason for a disqualification just because the wrong man's in the ring?
Well, you saw everything that was going on, Jesse. I mean, come on, give me a break.
Look at this, both of them.
But the referee doesn't see this. How can he disqualify for something he doesn't see?
Well, there's another reason right there. All right, there's another reason right there. Johnny V was up on the apron. That in and of itself is worthy of disqualification.
Because he stands up to point something out to the referee, he gets disqualified. Okay,
good job. Valentine Beefcake think they have won. They haven't won a cotton-picking thing. Stay with us, everybody. Coming up right now, a special update, and you won't believe it. Jake the Snake takes a shower with Damien.